When it comes to ComfyUI, we have a ComfyUI wrapper, and there's the workflow here. If you go down, it again tells you that it can peak at 12 gigabyte VRAM use, but most of the time it will be running at 9 to 10 gigabyte VRAM use if you are generating at this resolution. Then if you decrease the resolution, it can go down to 6 gigabyte VRAM. Okay, so when it comes to ComfyUI, if you'd like to give it a try, first change your directory and go into your ComfyUI folder, and then go inside the custom nodes folder, and then type in git clone, paste the GitHub link, restart your ComfyUI. Make sure that once you've restarted your ComfyUI, it says somewhere in the import times for custom node that the Pyramid Flow wrapper was imported successfully. So first we'll need to download the model. So for that, we'll add the download Pyramid Flow model. And this model type here, this is the one that you can change to in the FP8 version in case you do not have the VRAM requirements. Now this model flow will go into the sampler here. It will also go into the text encoder. The prompt embeddings goes into the sampler. I'm going to generate at a lower resolution just to check how much time it's going to take. Now for the samplers, we'll need to decode it. So let's do the pyramid VA decode. We'll take the model and the sampler. And then as you can see, it's going to output images. Now in order to see the images as a video, I'm going to go into the manager, custom node manager. At the top, I'm going to search for video and then install this ComfyUI video helper suite. Once it tells me to restart ComfyUI, I'm going to click on this restart button and then click on OK and just wait for ComfyUI to restart. Now, once ComfyUI has restarted, you should see video combine in your list. So just double click and add it. I'm going to change the number of frames to 24. And maybe let's just also add a preview image node so that we can see the individual images. By the way, you can copy and paste this text encode. And instead of sending this prompt embeds directly to the sampler, you can take it, send it to the previous prompt. Of course, you'll need to get the model. And then send this second one over to the ComfyUI Pyramid Flow sampler. So basically you're going to start with this prompt and then slowly change to this prompt. I've just added a busy city where people are walking and the snow is falling, and I'm still using the low resolution here just for this test to make sure everything is working correctly. Okay, let's click on cue prompt. It will automatically download and load the model. All right, so downloading the model took a while. It's about 20 gigabytes in size. So this low resolution completed, and we can see the result here. Again, there's a little bit of morphing happening, especially when we have so many people in here. And in case you're wondering, if you do select some kind of strange, weird resolution that the model has not seen before, this is the type of result that you can expect. So if you're getting this, make sure to change your resolution. All right, so that is it for today. Thank you for watching until the very end. Have a nice day, take care, and I will see you in the next one.